Genesis 7 is our Bible study this morning. Genesis 7, I read, "And Yahweh said unto Noah, Come thou and all thy house into the ark, for thee have I seen righteous before me in this generation. Of every clean beast that shall take to thee by seven, the male and his female, and of beasts that are not clean by two, and the male and the female, and fowls also of the air by sevens, the male and female, to keep seed alive upon the face of all the earth. For yet 7 days, and I will cause it to rain upon the earth, the 40 days and 40 nights, and every living substance that I have made will I destroy from off the face of the earth. And Noah did according unto all that Yahweh commanded him. And Noah was 600 years old when the flood of waters were upon the earth. And Noah went in, and his sons and his wife and his sons' wives with him unto the ark, because of the waters of the flood, of clean beasts and of beasts that are not clean, and of fowls and of everything that creepeth upon the earth. The air went in two and two unto Noah, unto the ark, the male and the female, as God has commanded Noah. And it came to pass after 7 days that the waters of the flood were upon the earth. In the 600th year of Noah's life, in the second month, the 17th day of the month, the same day where all the fountains of the great deeps broken up, and the windows of heaven were opened, and the rain was upon the earth 40 days and 49 nights. In the self same day entered Noah and Shem and Ham and Japheth, the sons of Noah and Noah's wife, and the three wives of his sons with them into the ark, they and every beast after his kind, and all the cattle after their kind, and every creeping thing that creepeth upon the earth after his kind, and every fowl after his kind, every bird and every sort. And they went in unto Noah, into the ark, two and two of all flesh wherein is the breath of life. And they that went in male and female of all flesh, as God has commanded him. And Yahweh shut him in, and the flood was 40 days upon the earth, and the waters increased and bare up the ark, and it was lifted up above the earth, and the waters prevailed and were increased greatly upon the earth, and the ark went upon the face of the waters, and the waters prevailed exceedingly upon the earth, and all the high hills that were under the whole heaven were covered. 15 cubits upward did the waters prevail, and the mountains were covered, and all flesh died that moved upon the earth, both the fowl and of the cattle and of the beast, and of every creeping thing that creepeth upon the earth, and every man, all in whose nostrils was the breath of life, of all that was in the dry land, died. And every living substance was destroyed which was upon the face of the ground, both man and cattle, and the creeping things, and the fowl of the heavens, and they were destroyed, both the earth and Noah only remained alive, and they that were with him in the ark. And the waters prevailed upon the earth 150 days. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise our Almighty Father Yahweh. Hallelujah. Flood. Flood. Genesis 7, verses 1 to 12. Noah and his family and the living creatures entered the ark, and the flood begins. Verse 2. Yahweh does not reveal the basis of his distinction between clean and unclean animals here. Noah predated Moses, who wrote down the dietary laws regarding which animals were ceremonially clean to eat. But the understanding of clean and unclean animals is left to believers. For unclean animals are symbols of the attitudes and behaviors Yahweh forbids to eat it. The call, because when you eat, that means you take in you. The call to Noah is very kind, like that of a tender father to his children to come indoors when he sees night or a storm coming. Noah did not go into the ark till Yahweh bade him, though he knew it was to be his place of refuge. It is very comfortable to see God going before us in every step we take. Noah had taken a great deal of pains to build the ark, and now he was himself kept alive in it. What we do in obedience to the command of Yahweh and in faith, we ourselves shall certainly have the comfort of it, first or last. This call to Noah reminds us of the call the gospel gives to poor sinners. Christ is an ark in whom alone we can be saved. When death and judgment approach, the word says, come. Ministers say, come. The Holy Spirit say, come. Come into the ark. Noah was accounted righteous, for not for his own righteousness, but as an heir of the righteousness which is by faith, as it is said in Hebrews 11, verse 7. He believed the revelation of a Savior and sought and expected salvation through him alone. How did he believe it? The seed of the woman. This is the first announcement of the coming of Christ, the Savior. Thus was he justified by faith and received that Spirit whose fruit is in all goodness. But if any man hath not the Spirit of Christ, he is not of his. After the 120 years, Yahweh granted 7 days longer space for repentance. But these 7 days, which equates to 7,000 years, if these are seven divine days, is to be multiplied by 1,000. So these 7 days, these 7,000 years were trifled away like all the rest. They passed their time, they were idle in those. They were reserved for repentance. It will be but 7 days. They had only 1 week, divine week more, one Sabbath more to improve and to consider the things that belonged to their peace. But it is common for those who have been careless of their souls during the years of their health, when they have looked upon death at a distance, to be as careless during the days, the few days of their sickness, when they see death approaching, their hearts being hardened by the deceitfulness of sin. And as Noah then, as Noah prepared the ark by faith in the warning given that the flood would come, so he went into it by faith, in this same warning that it would come quickly. And on the day Noah was surely fixed in the ark, the fountains of the great deep were broken up. The earth had within it those waters which at Yahweh's command sprang up and flooded it. And thus our bodies have in themselves those humors which, when God pleases, become the seeds and springs of mortal diseases. The windows of heaven open, and the waters which were above the firmament, that is, in the air, were poured out upon the earth. The rain comes down in drops, but such rain fell then as were never known before or since. It rains without stop or abatement 40 days and 40 nights, 40 years in human counting, 40 days in divine counting, upon the whole earth at once. As there was a peculiar exercise of the almighty power of Yahweh in causing the flood, it is vain and presumptuous to attempt explaining the method of it by human wisdom. But considering that the scriptures evoke divine days in Set, and that Noah is the ancestor of the Homo sapiens, that means our current race, our current species of humans, this swelling of the waters may explain the swallowing and tectonic displacement of continents, the glaciations, and the disappearance of the dinosaurs, the mammoth, and the different homos, you know, the Homo piens, the Homo sapiens, Homo this and Homo that. Genesis 7, verses 13, 16. Noah shut in the ark. The ravenous creatures were made mild and manageable. Yet when this occasion was over, they were of the same kind as before, once they were in. For the ark did not alter their natures. Hypocrites in the church, who outwardly conform to the days of that ark, are yet unchanged. And it will appear one time or another what kind they are after. Yahweh continued his care of Noah. Yahweh shut the door to secure him and keep him safe in the ark, also to keep all others forever out. In what manner was this done? God has not been pleased to make known. There is much of our gospel duty and privilege to be seen in Noah's safety in the ark. I quote, "To those who were disobedient long ago, when God waited patiently in the days of Noah while the ark was being built, in it only a few people, 8 in all, were saved through water. And this water symbolizes baptism that now saves you also. And also not the removal of dirt from the body, but the pleasure of a clear conscience toward God. He saves you by the resurrection of Yahshua Christ." End of quote. This is quoting 1 Peter 3 verses 20 to 21. Observe then, it is our great duty, in obedience to the gospel call, by a lively faith in Christ, to come into that way of salvation which Yahweh has provided for poor sinners. Those who come into the ark should bring as many as they can with them. By good instructions, by persuasions, and by good examples, there is room enough in Christ for all comers. God put Adam into paradise, but did not shut him in. So he threw himself out. But when God put Noah into the ark, and so when he brings a soul to Christ, the salvation is sure. It is not in our own keeping, but in the mediator's hand, Christ's hand. But the door of mercy will shortly be shut against those who now make light of it. Knock now, and it shall be opened. The scripture says this in Luke 13, verse 20 to 25. Genesis 7 verses 17 to 20, the increase of the flood for 40 days. The flood was increasing 40 days or 40,000 years. The waters rose so high that the tops of the highest mountains were overflowed more than 20 feet. Is this the symbol of the historical engulfing of lands and continents? There is no place on earth so high as to set people out of the reach of Yahweh's judgments. God's hand will find out all his enemies, as it is said in Psalm 21 verse 8. When the flood thus increased, Noah's ark was lifted up, and the waters which broke down everything else bore up the ark. That which to unbelievers indicates death unto death, to the faithful indicates life unto life. Genesis 7 verses 21 to 24. All flesh is destroyed by the flood. All the men, women, and children that were in the world, excepting those in the ark, died. All the fierce ages were swallowed up in the waters of history. We may easily imagine what terror seized them. Our Savior tells us that till the very day that the flood came, they were eating and drinking Our Lord Yahshua says it in Luke 17, verses 26 to 27. They were deaf and blind to all divine warnings. Is this posture deaf surprise? In this posture, death surprised them. They were convinced of their folly when it was too late. We may suppose they tried all ways and means possible to save themselves, but all in vain, because they could not save themselves. The same thing, you sinner, you cannot save yourself. You have to be in the ark, and the ark is Christ. And those who are not found in Christ, who is the ark, are certainly undone. Undone forever. Let us pause and consider this tremendous judgment. Who can stand before the Lord Yahweh when he is angry? The sin of sinners will be their ruin, first and last, if not repented of. The righteous God knows how to bring ruin upon the ancient world. The day of judgment and perdition of ungodly people. This is said in 2 Peter 2 verse 5. Happy are they who are part of Christ's family and saved with him as such. They may look forward without dismay and rejoice that they will triumph when fire will burn up the earth and all that is in it. We are apt to suppose some favorable distinctions in our own care or character, but if we neglect, refuse, or abuse the salvation of Christ, we will, notwithstanding such fancies advantages, be destroyed in the common ruin of an unbelieving world. Know this, and the Lord Yahweh will bless you. Amen. Hallelujah.